Haribo， 我们可以开始吗？
可以了 ，Gordon， 我们准备好了，可以开始。
Om Gyan Tamarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine。Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So we're on the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 1, about the history and life of Ajamila.
And the first... 我们现在学习的是圣典薄伽瓦坛第六篇，我们第一章是对于阿迦弥勒生平的描述。
We're beginning with the conversation between Sukadeva Goswami and Maharaj Parikshit.
我们是由 Sukadeva Goswami 和 Maharaj Parikshit 之间的对话开始讲起。
Maharaj Parikshit was concerned about all the hells which are there and the sinful people, how they have to suffer in hell.
Maharaj Parikshit 非常担心那些住在地那些罪恶的人会去到地狱，那些罪恶的人会去到地狱，非常担心他们。
So Sukadeva Goswami.In the beginning said that, well, they can be safe from going to hell if they do atonement. And he suggested that they could do some pious activities to counteract their sins.
Sukadeva Goswami 开始给 Maharaj Parikshit 的建议是他们可以通过忏悔之途来抵消他们的罪恶活动。
But Maharaj Parikshit was more intelligentAnd he knew that that wouldn't work, that wouldn't be sufficient.
Maharaj Parikshit 非常的有智慧，他觉得仅仅只是做这个忏悔之徒并不是足以有效果的。
He knew that just by doing pious activities, it won't stop people from sinful activities.
他知道一个人只是仅仅做虔诚活动的话，不能阻止他去做罪恶的活动。
So Sukadeva Goswami was pleased that Maharaj Parikshit was not going to be fooled.
Sukadeva Goswami 对此也感觉到非常满意，他觉得 Maharaj Parikshit 不是一个愚蠢的人。
So then Sukadeva Goswami said they can cultivate knowledge.
接着 Sukadeva Goswami 就说他们可以去培养知识。
And he talked about practicing brahmachari life and doing austerities and studying the scriptures. All of these things will help them to get free from sinful reactions.
他说他们可以去遵循 brahmachari 遵守身的这个生活，从事苦行，培养知识。所有的这些活动都能帮助他们抵御罪恶活动。
So they can be...purified from the sinful reactions by performing these different activities.
他们可以从事这些不同的活动来净化他们的罪恶活动的反应。
But the problem is that these sins are like dry leaves that are seated at the bottom of a bamboo tree.
但是这个问题就在于他们的罪恶就好像在竹林底下的那些枯草一样。
So they may be burned by fire, but the roots will grow again. After some time, the roots can grow back.
这些杂草有可能会被火给烧尽，但是过一段时间之后，由于这个杂草底下的根还在，所以这个杂草又会重新的生长出来。
So, how to remove the sins so that they won't grow back?
如何能够根除他们的罪，以致这些罪恶不再重返出来呢？
So Sukadeva Goswami explains that this is possible only for a rare person who takes up pure devotional service.
Sukadeva Goswami 就解释到，这种情况只发生在那些从事纯粹奉献服务的人的身上。
And he gives the example, he said, just like the sun will take away all the fog, when there's a lot of fog, if the sun comes out, then the fog will all be destroyed as soon as the sun comes out.
他举了一个比喻，就像阳光能够立刻驱除雾霾一样，当阳光一，虽然天空有很多的阳，有很多的雾霾，但是当阳光一出现的时候，这个雾霾就能立刻得到驱散。
We see here in Mayapur like that. Sometimes in the winter, in the morning, there'll be the fog. But as soon as the sun comes out, fog is gone.
我们在马雅普经常遇到这样的这个大雾的天气，尤其在冬天清晨的时候，有很大片的这个雾。但是当太阳一升起来的时候，全部都消散了，这些雾霾。
So because the sinful desires are still in the heart, if the root of the sinful desires is not removed, then the sinful desires will come again.
如果这个罪恶的欲望的根还在我们的内心没有被清除的话，它这个罪恶又会再一次出现，罪恶活动的愿望又会再一次出现。
So anybody who is not actually doing devotional service, they can always be tempted or fall into doing sinful activities.
任何不从事奉爱服务的人，他们都有可能会掉下来，然后再一次从事这些罪恶活动。
But if somebody becomes attached to devotional service, then he'll have no more desire for material enjoyment.
然而如果一个人他依念奉献服务，他对物质感官享乐的欲望就会消失。
If one is in Krishna consciousness, then he doesn't have an interest in performing pious or sinful activities.
如果一个人在 Krishna 知觉方面非常努力的话，他也没有兴趣去从事罪恶的或者说虔诚的活动。
Yeah, even pious activities are not attractive to a devotee because they're material and they keep us in the material world.
是的，即便是一个虔诚的活动，对于一个奉献者而言也没有那么大的吸引力，因为这些虔诚的活动还是不虔诚的活动都是物质的，它们不是灵性的。
So pious and sinful activities are due to ignorance.
虔诚的活动和不虔诚的活动实际上都是愚昧所致。
One who is in knowledge, he knows he's an eternal servant of Krishna.
一个真正有知识的人，他知道他是 Krishna 永恒的灵魂的永恒的仆人。
He doesn't have to do anything for sense gratification.
他没有任何想要从事感官享乐的欲望。
So this is the power of bhakti, devotional service to Krishna. Takes away the reactions of all the activities.
这就是 bhakti, 奉爱的力量，它能够把一个人从所有的活动的反应之中拯救出来。
So Maharaj Parikshit, he was a good devotee, and when he heard his guru Sukadeva Goswami speak about karma kanda and jnana kanda, he knew that this was not right.
Maharaj Parikshit 是一位伟大的奉献者，是一个很好的奉献者。他当他听到他的离性导师 Shukadeva Goswami 给他讲有关业报和思辨的这些方法的时候，这并不能使他得到满意，他认为这些方法并不是正确的。
So Sukadeva Goswami could understand also the heart of Maharaj Parikshit. He understood the mind or the heart of his disciple, and he understood his attraction to devotional service.
Sukadeva Goswami 也知道他的门徒 Maharaj Parikshit 的内心，他知道他的内心被奉献服务所吸引着。
So he knows, Sukadeva Goswami knows, not everyone can become Krishna conscious.
Sukadeva Goswami 知道不是所有的人都能具有 Krishna 知觉的。
Krishna consciousness is rare. Nobody understands Krishna. Practically, hardly anybody can understand Krishna because Krishna is the Supreme Lord.
Krishna 知觉是非常罕有的，基本上没有一个人能够完全的理解 Krishna.
He cannot understand Krishna by pious activities.
Krishna 不能通过虔诚活动去理解。
And you can't understand Krishna by simple knowledge.
我们也不能通过这些知识去简单的理解，不能通过知识理解 Krishna.
Okay, by the highest knowledge, then you can surrender to Krishna.
只有通过最高的知识，你才能够臣服 Krishna.
But that's very rare.
但这也是非常罕见的。
So foolish people, they think they're liberated just because they know they're not the body.
这些愚蠢的人只是认为他们不是这个躯体，他就认为自己得到了解脱。
Sometimes they think they've become Krishna, or they think they've become God.
有些时候他们还认为自己会成为 Krishna, 或自己就是神。
This is their ignorance.
这是他们的愚昧。
So we should understand what is real bhakti.
因此我们应该理解什么是真正的奉爱。
So Rupa Goswami describes the actual nature of bhakti yoga, that if one actually does bhakti yoga, then it takes away all distress.
是 Rupa Goswami 实际上讲述了奉爱服务的本性。他说如果一个人从事真正的奉爱的服务的话，能够摧毁他所有的沮丧。
And by doing devotional service you get all good fortune.
而通过奉献服务，他能够得到所有的好运。
And if we actually take up real bhakti, then liberation becomes nothing insignificant. It has no meaning to one who is in devotional service.
而如果一个人从事奉献服务的话，解脱对于他来说根本就毫微不足道。
But people who are not devotees, they're doing many sinful activities.
那些不是奉献者的这些人，他们经常从事罪恶。
And so their sinful activities are due to the caused by ignorance.
他们的罪恶活动来自于他们的愚昧。
So they're in different stages. There's some activities are more sinful than others.
有一些活动是比其他的行为要更为罪恶的。
And some sinful activity, some sinful reactions we're suffering from at the moment, and some are waiting in the future going to come and cause us suffering.
有一些罪恶活动它会立即得到反应，有一些罪恶活动会等待一段时间之后才会反应出来。
Sometimes, like we did sins in the past,and the reactions haven't fruit, they're still in the form of seed, they have not come out yet.
我们比如说我们在过去从事过一些罪恶活动，但是这些罪恶活动仍然在种，仍然像种子一样在我们的心里还没有发出来。
And there's many, many sinful reactions like that in our heart.
在我们的内心其实有很多很多这样的没有反映出来的罪恶活动的种子。
But the sins which we're suffering from at the moment, they can be seen in our body.
那些已经反映出来的罪恶活动的情况有可能在我们的躯体上显现出来。
Just like we may be born in a low family, or we may be suffering from some disease.
比如说，我们会出生在一个非常低等的家庭，或者因某种疾病而受苦。
We may have poor education.
或者我们的教育程度非常的低。
Or we may have, may not be good looking.
或者我们也长得不是那么的好看。
So these are all reactions due to our karma.
这些都是由于我们的活动造成的因果的反应。
But devotional service burns up all these sins.
但是奉献服务能够烧毁一切的罪恶。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna tells Uddhava, he said, just like a fire, a blazing fire, it burns all the wood to ashes.
在圣典波迦瓦坛，主 Krishna 告诉 Uddhava, 就像熊熊大火能够把所有的一切都燃烧成灰烬一样。
So in the same way, our sinful activities, the reactions of our sinful activities can all be burned up.By devotional service.
同样的，我们的罪恶活动也会被燃烧成灰烬。如果我们从事奉献服务的话，我们的罪恶活动也会被燃烧成灰烬。
Even we may be born in a family which eats dogs.
即便我们出生在一个吃狗者的家中。
But if we hear and repeat about the chanting of the Lord's name.
如果我们不断地重复唱诵主的名字的话，圣名的话
，Or if we offer respect to the Lord and we remember Him，
如果我们总是冥想着他，尊敬他
，Then even though we are born in a dog-eating family, we're better than a Brahmana。
那么，即便我们出生在一个吃狗者的家庭中，我们仍然会比一个婆罗门还要伟大。
And we're able to perform a Vedic yagya.
我们还有资格从事伟大的祭祀。
And if one is able to actually see Krishna directly, then he's the most purified.
如果一个人能够直接面对面的见到 Krishna 的话，他能够得到更大的。能够最大的得到净化。
So anybody whose heart is attached to the devotional service, they get free of their reactions from sinful life.
任何对奉献服务产生意念的人，他们能够立即免于所有罪恶活动的反应。
So these seeds are in different stages. Some seeds are they haven't sprouted yet.Some are waiting to sprout.
这些罪恶活动的种子有不同的形式的存在，有一些它正在准备产生结果，有一些没有产生结果。
And some have already sprouted, they're growing.
有一些已经存在，或者说已经在成长出来。
But devotional service, if we do pure devotional service, it destroys all of these sinful reactions.
如果我们能够从事纯粹的奉献服务的话，这就能摧毁我们所有的罪恶活动的反应。
Sinful life means we forgot our position as a servant of Krishna.
罪恶的生活意味着我们忘记了我们是 Krishna 仆人的身份和地位。
But when we become Krishna conscious, then we remember that we are Krishna's servant.
当我们具有 Krishna 知觉的时候，我们就记起来，我们是 Krishna 的仆人。
So devotional service can be also put into different stages, different categories.
奉献服务也可以被划成为不同的部分。
One kind of service is done constantly with full faith and love.
有一部分第一部分可以被称为持续不断的充满信心的和爱心的奉献服务。
And another kind is it's more interrupted. Sometimes service, sometimes not. Sometimes doing devotion, sometimes not. Not so regular.
另一个部分被称为间接的奉，或者说间歇性的奉献服务。有时候做奉献服务，有时候不做奉献服务，不是那种很规律的奉献服务。
And even when we do the service.In all the time without interruption, that can also be in different categories.
持续不断的奉献服务就是第一大种的奉献服务，也可以被分为两类。
It may be spontaneous devotional service.
一种是自发的奉献服务。
Or it may be with just a little attachment.
或者带着一点点的依恋之情的奉献服务。
And the irregular, unsteady devotional service, it can be also in different categories.
间歇的这种奉献服务也可以被分为三类。
It could be that we do service, we're almost attached.
第一种是几乎是充满着依恋之情的奉献服务。
Or it may be that there's no love, no real spontaneous love.
第二种是没有这种自发之爱的奉献服务。
But we just like to do service.
但是我们喜欢做奉献服务，但是没有自发之爱，我们只是喜欢做一些奉献服务。
Or it may be that there's a little bit of devotional service.
或者只是做了，第三种是只是做了一点点的奉献服务，就是沾一点边的奉献服务。
The different levels of performing devotional service.
因此从事奉献服务有很多不同的层面。
So, even if one has a desire to do sinful activities, one may...
即便一个人有这种想要从事罪恶活动的愿望。
But the root of that desire can be completely taken away by...even a little attraction to devotional service.
这种从事罪恶活动的根也会被那种有依恋之情的奉献服务的这种奉献服务所根除。
Just like as soon as the sun comes out in the morning, all the fog is away, vanishes.
就像当太阳出来的时候，所有的雾霭都会被清除一样。
So our sinful actions are like the fog.
我们的罪恶活动就像这些雾霭一样。
The sun just needs to come out, and all the fog is gone.
只要太阳一出现，所有的雾霾就会被清除。
So if we have a little relationship with bhakti, devotional service, then all of our sinful life can be.The effects of our sinful life can be removed.
即便一个人做了少许的奉献服务，他所有的罪恶活动的雾霭也会得到清除。
Then Sukadev Goswami tells Maharaj Pariksit, he said, if a sinful person, if they will serve a devotee, then they can get great benefit.
Sukadev Goswami 给 Maharaj Pariksit 说如果一个罪恶的之人，他服务真正的主的奉献者的话，他能够得到更好的益处。
He can learn how to dedicate his life to service to Krishna.
他能够把他的这一生献身于如何去服务 Krishna.
He can be completely purified.
他能够得到完全的净化。
But you cannot get such purification just by doing.Brahmacharya or austerity or any other methods.
而只是通过苦行真守身的生活或者其他的一些方法不能得到与之相同的净化。
So this, we can understand the importance of getting the association with the devotee.
由此我们可以理解到与一位奉献者联谊的好处重要性。
So this is talked about many times in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
这一点在圣典薄伽瓦坛被讲述过很多次。
If we want to get liberation from Maya, you have to associate with a Mahatma, with a pure devotee.
如果我们想从 Maya 物质能量 的束缚之中解脱出来，我们就必须和一位 Mahatma 纯粹奉献者联谊。
A Mahatma means one who is engaged all day, fully in the service of Krishna.
Mahatma 是一位一天二十四小时全心从事奉献服务的人。
So the sign of a Mahatma is that his only service is to Krishna. He has no other, not serving anybody else.
一位 Mahatma 的征兆是他只从事对主的奉献服务，他没有其他的活动。
So if we can associate with this person, he can train us how to love Krishna.
如果我们能够和这样的人联谊的话，他能够训练我们如何去服务 Krishna。
If we serve a pure devotee, then our sinful reactions will be destroyed. Hare Krishna. Hare Bal.
Hare Krishna, Gurudev.
What happened?
我听得见，您。
Oh, what a Sinha Bhuvending.
三七八的姐，您听见我最后的翻译了吗？
没有听到您的翻译，听到咕噜说了。
OK， 就是咕噜最后一句话是：如果人服务一位纯粹奉献者，其罪恶活动的反应就会被消除。
So we do devotional, the real purpose of our devotional service is not just to get free of our sins, but it's to get love of Krishna.
真正的奉献服务的意义不在于我们能够驱除，我们能够消除罪恶活动，而在于我们能够唤醒对 Krishna 的爱。
Just to get rid of sinful reactions, that's the mode of goodness.
如果只是驱除罪恶活动的反应，那只是在善良心态。
But we don't just want to be in the mode of goodness. We want to transcend the modes of nature. We have to develop love of Krishna.
我们不仅仅只是想处在善良心态，我们想超越这个情况，处在对 Krishna 的爱之中。
So a devotee wants to dedicate his life to Krishna.Not just to save himself from going to hell.
一个奉献者只是想献身于服务 Krishna, 而不是sorry, Gurudev.
He doesn't want to, it's not that we just serve Krishna because we don't want to go to hell.
Okay. 他服务 Krishna 的意义不是说想不去地狱而服务 Krishna.
A devotee will go anywhere for the service of Krishna.
奉献者会为了服务 Krishna 去到任何的地方。
So hell becomes heaven if Krishna is there, if Krishna's service is there.
地狱也会变成天堂，如果那里有奉献者，如果那里有奉献服务的话。
So one who is a devotee is not afraid to go anywhere for the service of Krishna.
如果一个人是奉献者的话，他不惧怕去任何地方。
He doesn't make any distinction between heaven and hell.
他对天堂和地狱不做任何的区分。
He just wants devotional service.
他只要奉爱服务。
So even if he's put into hell, he accepts it as Krishna's mercy.
如果他被处在地狱的状况之中，他会认为这是 Krishna 的仁慈。
Yeah, he doesn't think, oh, I'm a great devotee. Why did Krishna put me here?
他不会抗议说，哦，我是 Krishna 伟大的奉献者，为什么要把我放在这儿？
No, I think it's not Krishna's mercy.
不，他会认为这是 Krishna 的仁慈。
And he's willing to do service for Krishna in hell also.
即便他在地狱，他也想着要去做奉献服务。
And we see that example in the sixth canto, it's described the demon Vritasura.Vritasura, in previous life, he was a devotee, but he got cursed to become a demon.
我们在圣典薄伽瓦坛的第六篇聆听有关 Vritasura 的例子，也可以知道，他之前是一位奉献者，但是得到了诅咒，他成为一个恶魔。
But he never lost his devotion. He kept his bhakti and he was serving Krishna even in the demon body.
但他从来没有丢失过他的奉爱，即便他在一个恶魔的躯体里面，他也在想着做奉爱。
So the pure devotees are always well behaved, and they always have the best qualities.
一个纯粹的奉献者，他总是有很好的举止和行为，他有着最好的品质。
And the pure devotees are not afraid of anything.
一位纯粹奉献者，他从不害怕任何事情，不恐惧。
And they follow, they act according to the scriptures.
他的活动遵循着经典的，他遵循经典去活动。
So just because we're a devotee, it doesn't mean that we cannot do the rituals, the karmakandi activities.
Just because we are devotees, we are not doing the ritual.
Well, if he wants to, he can do them.
不是说我们是奉献者，我们就不做这种仪式。如果他想的话，他可以做这种伟大仪式。
But he knows it's not very important for him.
但是他知道，做伟大仪式对他来说并不重要。
Some people think that people who are on the path of devotion, that it's only for less intelligent people, like sentimental women and people who have no education.
有一些人认为奉献服务只是为那些感情用事的女性和那些没有智慧的人所准备的。
But there are many great scholars who follow bhakti.
但是仍然有很多伟大的学者，他们在遵循奉献服务。
Like Lord Chaitanya, he was a great scholar, very learned.
就像主柴坦尼亚，他也是一位伟大的博学者。
Ramanujacharya, he was also a great scholar.
Ramanujacharya, 他也是一位伟大的学者。
So they were great devotees.
他们都是伟大的奉献者。
So it doesn't matter if you're educated or not. It doesn't matter what your birth is.
因此，不管你是否接受过好的教育，不管你是否出生于好的家庭。
But we have to follow the path of the great souls.
我们都必须追随伟大灵魂的步伐。
We have to know who to follow, and we follow the example of the Mahajans, the great souls who teach devotional service.
我们应该知道，我们应该去追随谁？追随那些伟大的 Mahajan, 伟大的先辈儿，追随他们的奉献服务。
And they have all the good qualities of the demigods.
他们有。半神人的所有的美好的品质。
But some people think because you're doing bhakti, oh, you have no education, you have no good culture.
有一些人认为你们在从事这个奉爱之徒，所以你们没有很好的文化和教育，没有受到很好的文化和教育。
They think you don't know how to do karmakandi activities.
你们也不知道如何做 karmakanda 的这些活动。
But devotees know everything.
但是奉献者实际上知道一切。
So Mayavadis, they may be They may have good qualities, they may be well behaved.
这些 Mayavadi 或许是举止很得体的人。
But we don't think they can make much progress because they don't have the path, they don't have any connection to Krishna.
但我们知道他不可能取得很大的进步，因为他们和 Krishna 没有关系，没有联系。
They're not cultivating bhakti.
他们没有培养奉爱。
But the people who are on the path of bhakti, they have good qualities and they are saintly people and they're getting free from all fear. They have no fear.
但是那些追随奉爱之徒的人，他们有很好的品质，有圣洁的品质。而且他们能超越所有的奉，超越所有的恐惧。
So, in this way, they get liberated from Maya.
因此，他们能够从 Maya 之中得到解脱出来。
Sukadeva Goswami gives an example. He said, just like you may have a pot which has alcohol, some liquor, some alcohol in it.
Sukadeva Goswami 举了一个例子。就像一个罐子里面装了一些酒精一样。
So he said, doesn't matter how much you wash it, doesn't matter how many times you fill it with water and wash it out, you never purify it. It's always contaminated.
不管你把这个装满酒精的罐子冲洗多少干净，多么的清洁它总是被污染。
You'll always smell the alcohol.
你总能够闻到这个酒精的味道。
The same way, somebody who is not a devotee, even they do a lot of atonement, they will never get purification.
同样的道理，如果一个非奉献者，即便他做了很多的忏悔之徒，他也不能得到完全的，他也不能得到净化。
So, anybody who wants to actually atone for the sinful reactions, they have to have some bhakti.
因此，任何一个想真正利用忏悔之徒的人，他应该拥有一些奉爱之心。
Otherwise, if they don't have bhakti, they'll never get purified.
如果他没有奉爱之心的话，他永远不能得到净化。
It doesn't matter if they do karma kandi or jnana kandi.
无论他是做 karma 的活动，还是说，知识的活动。
But if they don't have bhakti, they cannot get purified.
如果他没有 bhakti 的话，他不会得到净化。没有奉爱的话，不能得到净化。
So Narottam Das Thakur, he says also the same thing.
Narottama Das Thakur 也说了同样的话。
It says like karma kanda and jnana kanda, they're just like a pot of poison.
Karma kanda 和 jnana kanda, 业报和思辨之布就像有毒液的罐子一样。
Just like you have alcohol or poison, they're the same thing. You cannot purify them.
装满酒精或者说装满毒液的这个罐子。都是一样，你无法净化它。
So somebody they may have heard about the path of devotion, but if they're not attached to it, if they have no Krishna consciousness, then they're just like that pot of alcohol or pot of poison.
一个人即便聆听了大量的奉献服务，如果他没有依念奉献服务，没有依念 Krishna 之觉的话，他就像一个装满。液体装满毒液的罐子一样。
You person wants to be purified, he has to have some bhakti.
一个人如果想要真的得到一些净化的话，他必须要有一些奉爱。
But somebody who even once surrenders unto the lotus feet of the Lord, then they can get great benefit.
但一个人如果哪怕一次臣服于主。他也能够得到最大的益处。
They haven't realized Krishna very much. They have only a little realization, not much.
他并没有完全的觉悟到 Krishna, 或者说觉悟那么多的 Krishna, 那么程度的 Krishna, 但是他有一点点理解 Krishna.
But somehow they're attracted to his name and to his form and his qualities.
或者由于某种情况，他被 Krishna 的名字、形体和品质所吸引。
So they get free from all their sinful reactions.
这样的人会摆脱所有的罪恶反应。
Because that is the real atonement, to take shelter of Krishna.
因为这是真正的忏悔之徒，脱避于 Krishna.
So these people, even in their dreams, they will not see Yamaraj.
而这样的人，即便在梦中也不会遇到 Yamaraj.
Yamaraj only comes to get the sinful people.
Yamaraj 只会去到那些罪恶的人的身边。
But these people, because even they just had a little attraction for Krishna, it saves them from going to hell.
而这样的人即便对 Krishna 只有一点点的吸引，就是被 Krishna 一点点的吸引，也能够拯救他免于去到地狱。
So if somebody studies the Bhagavad Gita and they decide to surrender to Krishna, immediately they get freed from sinful reactions.
如果人研习薄伽梵歌，决定臣服 Krishna 的话，他会立即免于所有的罪恶反应。
So Sukadeva Goswami, he had said words like Vasudeva Parayana, Narayana Parayana, and now he says Krishna Padara Vindayo.
Sukadeva Goswami 提到了很多，开始的时候他说 Vasudeva Parayana, Narayana Parayana, 然后到现在他说的是 Krishna Padara Vrindayo.
Yeah. So he knows Krishna is the origin of Narayana and Vasudeva.
所以他知道 Krishna 是 Narayana 和 Vasudeva 的根源 源头。
Krishna is the original supreme personality of Godhead.
Krishna 是原初的至尊人格首身。
And if we surrender to Krishna, then we also surrender to Narayana, to Vasudeva, everybody.
如果我们臣服 Krishna 的话，我们同时也臣服了 Narayana, Vasudeva 和所有的一切主的过程。
So Krishna is the Swayam Bhagavan, he's the original supreme personality of Godhead.
Krishna 是原初的那位至尊人格首身。
So Krishna says one should surrender to him only.
Krishna 说一个人只应该臣服于他。
So Prabhupada explains that neophyte devotees, they cannot understand who is the supreme.
对圣帕帕的说，对一个初级奉献者来说，他很难理解谁是至尊。
But Krishna speaking the Bhagavad Gita directly, he is saying, he is the supreme, there's no truth above him.
但是 Krishna 直接在薄伽梵歌说，他就是至尊，没有比他更高的真理。
So Maharaj Parikshit asked Sukadeva Goswami about how to save the fallen souls from hell.
Maharaj Parikshit 向 Sukadeva Goswami 询问的是一个人如何免于堕落到地狱的情况之中。
So Sukadeva Goswami told him that if they just surrender to Krishna, they cannot go to hell.
Sukadeva Goswami 的回答，这里的回答是，如果一个人臣服 Krishna, 他肯定不会去到地狱。
And even in his dreams, he will not see the servants of Yamaraj.
而且即便是在他的梦中都不会遇到 Yamaraj.
So any person who's worried about going to hell, they just have to surrender to Krishna.
因此，任何那些担心、害怕去到地狱的人，他们只需要臣服 Krishna 就行。
Even you're the most sinful person, you've done many sins, but if you surrender to Krishna, you can be saved.
即便他是一个非常罪恶的人，从事了很多的罪恶活动。如果他臣服 Krishna 的话，也能得到拯救。
And a little bit of devotional service can save us from the greatest danger.
一点点的奉献服务也能够把我们从最大的罪恶之中拯救出来。
So that the most auspicious, the best thing we can do is to surrender to Krishna.
而我们能够做的最好的事情就是臣服 Krishna.
Save us from the hellish life.
能够拯救我们从地狱的生活之中拯救出来。
So sinful actions are like a snake.
罪恶的活动就像蛇一样。
But when one surrenders to Krishna, then it's like the poison fangs are cut from the snake.
但是如果我们臣服 Krishna, 这个罪恶活动就好像这个毒蛇的牙齿被拔掉了一样。
Sometimes the people come to the village and they bring the big snake with them.
有一些人他们去村庄带着一条大蛇。
And a big cobra snake, which can, you know, the cobra is very poisonous.
比如说他们带着那个眼镜蛇，那个眼镜蛇是非常有毒的。
But they cut out the teeth so that the snake cannot bite.
他们于是就把这个牙齿给毒蛇的牙齿给拔掉，这样这个蛇就不能咬人。
So the snake, although it looks frightening, it cannot bite. It cannot do any harm.
因此这个蛇即便看上去很可怕但是它实际上不能咬人。
So anyway, we shouldn't do anything sinful because if we do sins, then we suffer.
不管怎么样我们都不能从事罪恶活动因为我们只要一从事罪恶活动就会受苦。
Maybe we, because of form bad habits, maybe from the past,We had some bad habit and we just forgot. So Krishna can forgive us once or twice, but not all the time.
或许是由于我们过去的习惯或者说过去的情况导致我们有这种从事罪恶活动的倾向。我们但是由于 Krishna 仁慈他可能会原谅我们一到两次但不会总是那样原谅我们。
So we have to learn to take shelter of the instructions of the spiritual master and that will save us from all fear.
因此我们应该脱避于灵性导师的训示他这样就能够拯救我们。
So Sukadeva Goswami is now going to begin, he's going to tell a story which he heard, actually in something which happened in the past, from the history.
接下来舒卡迪巴戈斯瓦米就会为我们讲述一个在过去的历史上所发生的一个事情。
And he's going to tell about a discussion which took place between the order carriers of Lord Vishnu and the servants of Yamaraj.
这个事情发生在主威士努的执行官和 Yamaraj 的执行官之间的一场辩论。
So this is a history, it's from the scriptures called the Puranas. Puranas means history.
这个事件被描述为描述在 Purana 上。Purana 的意思是历史、古史。
So some people they don't like to hear the Puranas. They say, "Oh, this is just stories. It's not true. It's just mythology, fairy tales like that."
有一些人他不太认可 Purana 不太认可这个故事他们认为这些叙述是不真实的只是一些故事而已
But actually everything in the Puranas is true It's...
事实上发生在 Purana 上的一切事情都是真实的
It's the history of the universe But it's not in any special order It's not in any chronology
事实上记载在 Purana 上的所有的事实是真实的它是叙述是真实的而只是不是按时间顺序记述的而已
Right And sometimes they'll tell something which took place in another Divya Yuga millions and millions of years ago
有一些时候是记载在另外一个年代里面那些年代或许是千百万百万年以前所发生的事情
And it may be something which happened not in this universe, but in another universe.
或许还会记载不是在这个宇宙所发生的，而是在其他宇宙上所发生的一些事情。
Or maybe some things which took place on another planet, not maybe within this universe, but on a different planet.
或许是在这个宇宙，但是不是在这个星球上，而是其他星球上的事情。
So some people, they don't accept the Puranas. They say, no, it's all just stories. It's nothing true.
有一些人他不接受 Purana, 他们认为这只是故事，不是真实的。
But Rupa Goswami, he accepts the Puranas. He says it's very important to help us understand the Vedas.
但是是 Rupa Goswami, 他接受 Purana. 他认为 Purana 跟伟达经是一样重要的。
He said that Puranas, they may be, the Puranas of course are Smriti, they're not Shruti, the Vedas are Shruti, but the Puranas are Smriti, but it should be accepted.
Purana 是, 是 Smriti, Veda 是 Shruti, 他们或许这个 Purana 不是 Shruti, 但是它和伟达经是一样重要的。
But Rupa Goswami, he quotes a verse from the scriptures which says that we do devotional service according to both the Shruti and the Smriti and the Puranas and the Pancharatriki.
Rupa Goswami 引用了一个诗节说 Shruti 和 Smriti 是一样重要的，我们也需要伟达经，也需要 Purana。
Yeah, there are 18 Puranas, 6 for each mode of nature.
有18部 Purana, 每一个都针对不同的属本性。
And then you have the Shruti, it's the 4 Vedas, and the Upanishads are in the Vedas.
Shruti 是有四部伟达经，而伊舍乌帕尼沙的至尊奥义书也是属于伟达经。
No, there's 108 Upanishads, they're all in the Vedas.
有108部奥义书，他们都属于伟达经。
And then Pancharatriki, we have the book by Narada Muni, Narada Pancharatra.
我们有一本书叫 Narada Pancharatra.
Yes, about deity worship.
他是谈神像崇拜的。
And so if we do devotional service without following the scriptures, then it's just a disturbance to society.
这一节诗描述到，如果我们从事奉献服务，不遵循这些经典 Purana 和伟达经的话，还有这个 Narada Panchara 的话，只是对社会不必要的骚扰。
A devotee of Krishna must refer to the Vedas.It must also refer to the Puranas.
Krishna 的奉献者不仅应该遵循伟达经，也应该谈及 Purana, 就是 Purana 往事书这个古史。
We should understand that if Sukadeva Goswami is going to tell some incident from the Puranas, it must be real.
我们应该理解到，如果是 Sukadeva Goswami 讲述的一些，引述的这个 Purana 的话，它应该是非常真实的。
Sukadeva Goswami is a very advanced self-realized soul.
Sukadeva Goswami 是非常精进的灵魂。
And we accept him as the authority.
我们接受为他为我们的权威。
So he's going to tell the story about Ajamila.
他将会我们讲述这个阿姜米拉的故事。
Okay, so maybe we'll begin that tomorrow, next class.
Okay.
Are there any
questions?
Yeah.
First question from Sumukhi Radha Dasi. 请问 Guru, 我们与圣人的交往中觉得圣人不完美，这是我们自己的问题，还是圣人？的确有不完美之处呢。I want to ask a guru, when we communicate with some saint people, we find that these saint people are not, these sadhu are not perfect. So is this our problem or the sadhu the sadhu have some things that are not perfect.
Well, it depends. What is your relationship with the sadhu?
这个取决于你和萨杜之间的关系。
Are you taking knowledge? Is he giving you instruction? If he's giving you if you're taking guidance from him, if you're looking to him for inspiration, then it's a problem for you as well as him.
如果你是从他那里接受指导的话，这个问题是 this problem is you, is yours.
Yeah, and it's his also.
这个问题既是你的也是他的，就是如果你是从这位圣人那里接受知识的话，你发现这样的情况，那这个问题也是你的问题，也是他的问题。
You want to, if you say he's a sadhu, then sadhu is supposed to have good qualities. Why? That means he's not really a sadhu. If he's still got problems, if he's got faults, it's not good.
如果他是一位沙杜的话，意味着他应该有完美的品质。如果你他身上发现一些问题的话，意味着他有一些错误，这不是很好。
You have to consider what kind of faults he has. Are these faults something which are going to go away in course of time? Are they going to stay and get worse?
你也得考虑他的这个错误到底是一种什么样的错误。这个错误是他过一段时间就会消除呢，还是说这个错误会一直伴随着他？
So, anyway, if you know he has faults and something wrong, then you don't have to get too close. You don't have to take guidance from him.
不管怎样，如果你发现他真有一些错误的话，你不应该和他靠得有太近的关系，或者你不应该从他那里接受这个指导。
You have your right, you have your independence, you have the right to decide who you want to hear from and who you want to take guidance from.
你有你的权利和独立性选择，你应该从谁那里接受灵性的指导。
You're not required to hear from everyone.
你没有要求说，就是没有人要求你说你从每一个人那里接受聆听。
In ISKCON, we have many senior devotees. We have many people in the movement. They've been around. Some of them have been around a long time.
在我们的这个伊斯康有很多的灵性导师，有一些在我们身边已经有很长时间。
But just because we've been around a long time doesn't mean that we're perfect.
但并不意味着他在我们这个里面待了很长时间就意味着他是完美的。
So you have the right to choose for yourself who you want to associate with, who you feel confident in.
因此你有你的权利去选择谁让你更加有自信，或者说你想和谁在一起联谊。
Is that clear, Sumukhi Radha? Is there some, you want to ask any more question on this?
Sumukhi Radha Mataji, 您清楚了吗？或者说您想更进一步询问呢？
This is something which could be discussed at some length.
这是一个我们可以讨论很长时间的一个话题。
Okay,
next,
no response. Okay.
Next question from Yuna. She writes in English. It is believed that we cannot approach Krishna without the mercy of the Lord Nityananda. How can we get the mercy of the Lord Nityananda? 他说，据说如果没有得到尼天丹的主尼天丹的仁慈，无法得到 Krishna 的仁慈。但是我们那我们如何得到主尼天丹的仁慈呢
？Well, you can get the mercy of Lord Nityananda by taking up the mission of Lord Nityananda.
我们得到主尼天丹的仁慈，可以通过接，就是。抓住主尼天丹达的使命，去完成他的使命，去得到他的仁慈。
Try to deliver Lord Nityananda. Try to deliver the fallen souls.
主尼天丹达试着在解脱这些罪恶的灵魂。
So if you can also take up that kind of work to deliver the fallen souls, to give them Krishna consciousness, that will qualify you for the mercy of Lord Nityananda.
如果你抓住这个使命去试着拯救那些堕落的灵魂的话，那么你可以得到主尼天丹达的仁慈。Next question.
Yes.
Next question from Sachi Sundari Devidasi. 顶拜古德莲花族，顶拜翻译和主持。圣维亚萨赐给桑杰亚。是灵性的誓欲还是半神人的誓欲无限的感恩、obeisance to Guru's lotus feet I want to ask the Srila Vyasa give the spiritual vision to the Sanjaya is this spiritual vision is spiritual vision or the demigod vision
Well, he gave the power to see the battlefield, what was going on the battlefield.
他给予他的力量让他看到在战场上所发生的一切。
I wouldn't describe it as spiritual vision or the vision of the demigods.
我不能描述他是半神人的誓欲还是灵性的誓欲。
He gave them some power, mystic power, that he could see what was going on the battlefield.
他只是给予他一种力量，一种神秘的力量，让他看到在战场上所发生的一切。Next question from 小苹果 ，Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， 顶拜翻译和主持，请问 Goloka 也有灵师学校吗？跟地球上文达文的临时学校一样吗 ？Krishna 在 Goloka 的临时学校也上演了很多逍遥时光吗？感恩 Guru Day。Obeisance to Guru, I want to ask: In the Goloka, is there a Guru Kula? That Guru Kula is the same in this world in this earth in the Vrindavan?
No, I think in Goloka they don't have the Gurukula because in Goloka all the cowherd boys they go out to the forest with the cows.
我想在这个 Goloka 在灵性天空的 Goloka 没有这个 Gurukula。因为所有的牧牛童都出去放牛去了。
And even Gokula on this planet, the Gurukula is when Krishna went to Gurukula, he didn't go to Vrindavan, he went to another place to go to Gurukula.
即便在这个地球上，当 Krishna 去 Gurukula 的时候，他不是去 Vrindavan 的 Gurukula。而是去到另外一个地方的 Gurukula。
He went to the Gurukula Sandipani Muni's ashram. Krishna and Balaram, they went together. They went to Sandipani Muni's ashram, which is in Avantipur. Avantipur today is called Ujjain.
他和 Balaram 去到 Sandipani 的 ashram, 那里的咕噜窟了，就是 Ashram。 而那个 Sandipani 的居所在今天的这个，在今天被称为 Ujjain 的这个地方，不是本达门， Ujjain 的地方。
So but anyway, in traditionally the village boys in Vrindavan, they didn't really need to go to Gurukula because they were just taking care of cows.
在 Gurudev, you mean in the earth plane, our earth, Vrindavan, they no need to go to Gurukula.
So, in Vrindavan, in this world,
in this world, okay. In this world, Vrindavan, these mu-liu-tong, they don't need to go to Gurukula, because they just want to go
to Gurukula. What other question?
There's another question. Krishna in Goloka, Gurukula, they also have a many pastime.
Gurukula.
这个问题您刚刚回答说在灵性世界的格罗卡是没有 Gurukula， 所以这个问题也相当于回答。
Yeah. 我们没有听过 Krishna 有 Gurukula 在灵性世界。No, in the spiritual world, we didn't hear that Krishna went to Gurukula.Krishna just takes care of the cows. Every day goes to forest with the cows.
在灵性世界 ，Krishna 没有去古鲁库了，就是说我们没有听到有关这样的事实。Krishna 只是每天和牧牛童们去放牛。
Krishna is eternally youthful in the spiritual world.
Krishna 在灵性世界永远是年轻的。
We don't hear about his taking birth, about him being a baby in the spiritual world. We only hear about him as a young man.
我们没有听到他在灵性世界是一个小孩子，我们听到他是一个年轻的男子。
And every day he takes care. He goes with the cowherd boys. They go to the forest, and every night they come back.
每一天和牧牛童。去森林里面，然后到晚上的时候就回来。Next question from Hari Vamsa Prabhu. 请问 Guru， 牧牛姑娘和 Krishna 的年龄差距是多少？牧牛姑娘和牧牛女有区别吗？ This question from Hari Vamsa. I want to ask the gopis and the, what's the different age between the gopis and the Krishna?
Well, there's young gopis and there's older gopis.
有年轻的牧牛姑娘，有年纪大一点的牧牛姑娘。
The older gopis are mothers. They have children. They have their own families.
年纪大的牧牛姑娘们有他们的孩子，也有他们自己的家庭。
And the young gopis, you know, just like Radharani, she's younger than Krishna.
我们听到有年轻的牧牛姑娘们是比 Radharani 是比 Krishna 要年轻的。
Younger than Krishna by what, 2 weeks or something?
好像是两个星期，比他年轻两个星期。
I'm not sure how many years Krishna was.A little baby, he was still a child. When Radharani was born, Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda came to visit Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Kirtida. So they brought Krishna to see Radharani.
当 Radharani 出生的时候 ，Vrishabhanu 王去到 Krishna 的家，把 Krishna 带到 Radharani 那你去见 Radharani。
So that time Krishna was still crawling, just still a baby.
那个时候 Krishna 还是一个小婴儿，小孩子。
So he's a little bit older than Radharani, not much.
他只是比 Radharani 要稍微大一点点， 不是特别多。Then he asked, what's the difference between the younger gopis and the gopis? Younger gopis and the older gopis.
What's the difference? Well, the older gopis.
他说木流姑娘和木流女。I think he means, what's the difference between the younger gopis and the elder gopis?
The difference is the older gopis will be married and they'll be more in, like a mother to Krishna. And the young gopis, they're more in Madhurya Ras. They think of Krishna as their lover.
这些年长的一些木流女，他们跟木流姑娘，年轻的木流姑娘们的区别是，年长的这个木流姑娘们，他们有自己的家庭之后，他们认为自己是相当于是 Krishna 的母亲的这个地位的这个状态，而年轻的木流姑娘们，他们是处在 Madhura Rasa， 也就是说和 Krishna 是伴侣的这种关系的状态之中。
Yeah. So according to the Rasa, the one will be the older gopi and one will be the younger gopi, according to the particular mood they have towards Krishna.
根据他们的 Rasa 和跟 Krishna 的心态，他们处在年老的年纪大的木流姑娘和年轻的木流姑娘的这种不同的情况之中。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Sati Madhaji. Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤儿的莲花组。有一次，圣帕布帕德问他的一位普加瑞门徒，问他在装扮神像时是什么心绪？请问。发布这种服务心绪是我们可以逐渐培养并最终与主的关系被唤醒，还是这种关系原本就固定的，会慢慢通过服务展示出来？ Hare Krishna, basis to Guru's lotus feet. One time the Srila Prabhupada asked one Pujari disciple, what's the mood when he decorate the deities?So I want to ask, this survey the mood is that we can cultivate time by time, or is time by time, and finally this relationship can be wake up, or another option is this relationship is already fixed, and when we do the devotional service, this relationship can be shown.
Let me
make it simple. Simply, he wants to ask our relationship.This mood is one way is we can cultivate slowly and slowly, and then this can 最终与主的关系被唤醒。He want to ask our relationship between me and the Krishna. This relationship is already fixed, or it will be changed.
Yes, it can be changed. We do have an eternal relationship with Krishna, but we may be going through other relationships before we come to that relationship.
We have an eternal relationship with Krishna, but we may be going through other relationships before we come to that relationship.我们可能在到达这个永恒关系之前会有其他的这种关系。
Just like in the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, it tells about Gop Kumar, how Gop Kumar went through different relationships.
就像在大伯加瓦坦甘露之洋中，我们谈到了 Gopa Kumar 他经历的不同的关系。
He went to the Brahman, he wasn't satisfied there. He went to Vaikuntha, he wasn't satisfied.
他去到 Brahman, 他去到 Vaikuntha, 但是也不满意。
Then he went to Dwarka, and he wasn't fully satisfied.
然后他去到 Dwarka, 他也没有得到完全的满足。
And so they told him, you know, you have to go to Goloka to be fully satisfied.
因此他被告知，你应该去到 Goloka, 这样你会得到完全的满足。
So until we find a place where we actually belong, we won't be fully satisfied.
在我们没有达到完我们这个原本的这个位置的时候，我们不会得到满足。
So we can go in these different places, but if it's not meant to be our place, we won't be satisfied there.
我们可能会去到不同的地方，但是如果不是我们原本的位置的话，我们不会得到满足。Next question from Yuna.
Oh, Hare Krishna.
Yes, yes.
Sorry, Gurudev, 我还想问，那就是当我们这个服务神像的时候，我们这种心态应该是怎样一种心态呢？就是
Well, you have to consider what deity you're serving and what is your own mood in serving the deity. You know, if you're serving Gornitai.You want to be in the mood of an associate of Lord Chaitanya. You want to be maybe thinking about Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan movement. You want to be thinking of yourself as a servant of Lord Chaitanya.
在服务神像的时候，得考虑你服务神像的时候，你是服务的哪一种神像。如果你是服务的是谁高尔尼泰的话，你可以想你是主柴坦尼亚的同游，或者说你是他的仆人，你想的是他的桑切坦齐颂圣名的这个运动。
Sati, 你也这星期二也有一些问题吗？我没回答，你给他吗？
对。不对，就刚才回答的这些都是星期二的留下来的问题。
哦，好，
都已经到这里回答完了。
好，谢谢。
下面的是今天的问题。
好，
萨提玛吉，您还问吗？
可以了，可以，谢谢 Good Day。
OK，Next question， Good。
Uh-huh.
From Yuna。She also writes in English, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble basis. If Lord Krishna take everything from us, for example, property, relatives, home, and if as a result of it we come to Krishna consciousness, is it the mercy of Krishna or is our karma? 他问的这个问题是，如果 Krishna 把我们的一切都拿走，比如说我们的财产、我们的亲人、我们的家人，这是我们的 Krishna 知觉的结果，还是说 是 Krishna 知觉结果的仁慈 ，Krishna 仁慈的展示，还是说是我们的业报
？Nobody comes to Krishna consciousness because of karma.
没有人会因为业报而进入到 Krishna 知觉。
You need the mercy of a devotee.
我们得需要。
So you didn't come to Krishna consciousness just because Krishna took everything away from you.
你进到 Krishna 知觉不是因为 Krishna 把你的一切都拿走。
There must have been some devotee gave you some mercy, gave you the help, gave you contact to Krishna.
一定是 Krishna 的奉献者给予你连接 Krishna 的方法。
So it said, by the mercy of Krishna, you get the mercy of the devotees.
通过 Krishna 的仁慈，你得到的是奉献者的仁慈。
By the mercy of the devotees, you get the mercy of Krishna.
通过奉献者的仁慈，你得到 Krishna 的仁慈。Okay. Next question from Divya Shakti David Dasi.顶拜 Gurudev 的莲花组感恩翻译，我学习圣典波迦瓦坛觉得很难，我怎么读懂瓦坛呢？谢谢 Guru 给我的训示，请给您的训示。Obeisance to Guru Lotus Feet. When I studied the Srimad Bhagavatam, I felt it difficult. How can I understand how can I understand that? How can I read and understand the Srimad Bhagavatam? Thank you, Gurudev.
Well, you have to be guided by someone to help you.
你需要一个人来指导你阅读。
Maybe it would be better to first of all focus more on Bhagavad Gita and get a good grounding in the Bhagavad Gita.
或许在开始的时候你应该更专注于学习《博伽梵歌》。
And gradually you can come to understand Bhagavatam.
逐渐的你再能够理解圣典《博伽梵歌》。
Bhagavad Gita will bring you to the platform where you're more able to understand the Bhagavatam.
博迦梵歌会帮助你带到能够理解圣典博迦瓦坛的层面上。
But you can keep reading, and you don't understand, okay? So you can ask questions, tell us what's the problem, what do you not, maybe you have to be guided a little bit to understand what's happening.
你可以继续的阅读，没有问题。当你有问题的时候，你可以提出来，到底发生了什么？我们可以指导你。
Now the Srimad Bhagavatam, the first three slokas, the first chapter of the first canto, first three slokas, are like an invocation before the Bhagavatam actually begins.
圣典博迦瓦坛的第一篇的前三个诗节就像圣典博迦瓦坛开始的一个介绍或者说前言一样对于整个博迦瓦坛的一个描述。
And then the chapter begins with the questions by the sages.
而 他们的这个问题来自于这个圣典博迦瓦坛所提问是由圣人们所提出的问题而开始的。
Yeah, there's many sages gathered in the Naimisharanya forest, and they know Kali Yuga is going to begin, so they have a lot of questions.
在这个莱米沙拉雅森林有很多的圣人，他们聚集在一起，因为卡利年代又开始。
So the first chapter, they put questions to Sutta Goswami.
因此在开始的时候他们呈现给苏塔戈斯瓦米这些问题。
And you'll hear in the first chapter also, what are the qualifications of the speaker and what are the qualifications of the audience?
在开篇的时候你还可以聆听到对于一个聆听者和一个讲述者他们的资格分别是什么。
Then the second chapter,Sutta Goswami starts to answer the questions.
在第二章的时候 Sutta Goswami 将会为我们解释将会回答这些世人所提出的问题。
So you read that first chapter again.
这样你再一次阅读这一个
the first chapter. The first, read the first.
你就再一次阅读第一章。
And you can start from text number 4.
你可以从第一章的第一篇第一章的第四个诗节开始。
And you note the qualities of the speaker and the qualities of the audience.
你知道讲述者和聆听者的资格。
And list the questions which are asked.
列出他们所提出的这些问题。
And send it to me, and I will check to see if you're right.
然后你把这些问题列出来之后发给我，然后我会检查看你是否准备好了。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Tapan Mishra Das. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，感恩翻译。请问为什么奉献服务可以清除一个人的物质欲望？我们如何向非奉献者解释你这一点 ？Obeisis to Guru Maharaj, I want to ask why the devotional service can destroy one's material desire. How can we explain to the non-devotees about this point?
Because devotional service is connected to Lord Krishna, And Lord Krishna is the supreme pure.
因为奉献服务和 Krishna 连接，而主 Krishna 是至尊纯粹的。
Just like in the presence of the sun, there can be no darkness.
就像当太阳出现的时候，是没有黑暗的。
So where there is devotional service, there can be no ignorance.
因此，当有奉献服务的时候，就没有愚昧。
So material desires are ignorance, and they are all purified by devotional service.
物质愿望都是愚昧，它可以被奉献服务所净化。
Yeah.Shaggy, are you going to me?
Yes, this question from Tom. Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤儿的莲花族，对于刚开始托庇于灵性导师的奉献者，与孤儿的联谊，怎样才是恰当的？怎样与孤儿更好的连接？ Hare Krishna, basis with Guru's lotus feet. For the neophyte devotees that just take shelter from the spiritual master,when they get association with the spiritual master, what is the proper activities? How to better connect with the guru?
Well, the main business is to hear from the spiritual master. And if you have questions, you can also put your inquiries before the spiritual master.
对于开始的奉献者，最主要的工作就是去聆听。如果你有问题的话，你也可以在你的灵性导师面前呈现出来。
The exchange between the spiritual master and the disciple is based like that on hearing and inquiry.
灵性导师和门徒之间的这种关系交流，基于聆听和询问。
Your inquiry should be in relation to Krishna consciousness.
而你的询问也应该和 Krishna 知觉有关。
I am not able to guide you in your material life.
我不是特别有能力在你的物质生活方面指导你。
You know, I know some of our devotees, they have families and they have things like jobs and family relationships, and they may come to me and ask me what to do. It's very difficult for me to tell you what to do.
有很多的门徒或许来到我的面前，给我讲他的家庭、他的工作所遇到的这些问题。对于我来说，很困难告诉你，很困难，我很难以告诉你怎么做。
But if you have questions about Krishna conscious philosophy or the process of devotional service, then you can inquire and I can try to help you.
但是如果你的问题是有关于 Krishna 知觉的哲学，或者说修习 Krishna 知觉的这些程序，我可以帮助你。Next question, Gurudev. A from Amy. 顶拜孤的莲花组顶拜翻译和主持人，请问 Guru, 为什么越修习越感到物质世界的苦呢？心里的伤感也越来越多，有没有修错呢？A basis to Guru's lotus feet, I want to ask why when we practice more and I feel the more sufferings in the material world.And the more depressed in our hearts, am I practice wrong?
No, I don't think so.
我不是这样认为的。
I think it's you're becoming more aware of the nature of the material world.
你开始变得越来越意识到这个物质世界的本性了。
That initially, before becoming a devotee,It was the same material world, but you were not aware of all the misery of the material world.
而在你修习奉献服务之前，你是没有意识到这个物质世界的痛苦。
And you were thinking sense gratification is the goal of life.
你会认为感官享乐就是生活的目标，生命的目标。
But now, after being a devotee, you have a different understanding.
但是当你成了奉献者之后，你会有不同的理解。
You realize that sense gratification is just chewing the chewed.
你会认为感官享乐只是在咀嚼那些已经咀嚼过的东西。
That actually sense, what we think is happiness in the material world was not really happiness at all. It was very low, very poor, very unpleasant situation.
我们所认为的这些物质世界的感官享乐的快乐，实际上并不是令人感觉到那么的愉悦，而且是非常低等的，非常贫乏的。
Just like before becoming a devotee, what would we would do for, we would think party, and we would think enjoy alcohol and illicit activities, sinful activities, and we were thinking this is enjoyment.
比如说当我们来到奉来成为奉献者之前，我们会认为聚餐，然后酒精，还有等等这些罪恶活动，认为这些就是感官享乐，这些就是快乐。
So we were going to hell very fast, very quickly, with all our sinful activities.
而通过这些活动，我们会很快地下到地狱去。
But we were not thinking we're going to hell. We were thinking I'm enjoying.
但是我们当时并不认为我们会去到地狱，我们会认为我们是在享受。
We were in such ignorance, we didn't know.
我们处在如此的愚昧情况之下，我们并不知道。
But after becoming a devotee, then we're more thoughtful and we're more careful.
当我们成为奉献者之后，我们会更有思想。
We're very careful about the sinful activities to avoid them.
我们也会非常小心这些罪恶活动，去避免这些罪恶活动。
And we have we do have pleasure, we still enjoy, but we take pleasure in spiritual activities.
我们仍然在这个物质世界，我们仍然想要快乐，但是我们想要的这种快乐是在灵性的活动之中想要获得的。
We take pleasure in chanting the holy name of Krishna.
我们是通过唱诵 Krishna 的圣名来获得快乐。
We take pleasure in being with the devotees.
我们的快乐是来自于和奉献者在一起联谊的这种快乐。
So it's a very different taste from the material life. It's a different experience from before becoming a devotee.
这是一种完全不同于我们成为奉献者之前的这种体验。
Now we have a higher taste.
现在我们有更高的品味了。
Before we had a very low taste.
在之前我们的品味非常的低级。
But we have upgraded our standard of activities.
但是我们提升了我们活动的品质。
Yeah.
Next question from Varshashundari Mataji. Hare Krishna, 感恩 Guru 带给我们的甜美甘露，感恩翻译的甜美服务。在《薄伽梵歌》的第七章十六节是讲到四类虔诚的人为 Krishna 做奉献服务。请问 Guru 对 Naimisharayana 森林中圣人们，他们属于是好奇爱问者，还是属于探寻绝对真理者？In the obeisance to Guru Dev, in the Bhagavad Gita chapter 7, verse 16, it said four pious people do the devotional service. I want to ask, in the Naimisharanya, the sages, are they belong to the people who like the knowledge, or they belong to the people who are very curious?
They belong to curious people.
他们属于好奇爱问者。
Yeah, they have many inquiries. They don't know. They don't know.
他们有很多的这种问题，他们不知道。
Remember, there's all kinds of sages there. All different. They're not all devotees.
那里有很多的圣人，但是他们不全都是奉献者。
Many different kinds of great sages all came.
有很多不同种、不同的这种圣人都来了。
So they have inquiries. So they are the inquisitive people.
他们是，他们都有他们的问题，他们是好奇的人，好奇爱问者。
But
next question.
The people who want knowledge, that's the four kumaras.
那些探寻绝对真理的人是四库马尔为代表。Next question from Shyamaki, Mataji. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev 和所有的奉献者。我的问题是，主 Krishna 在 Goloka Vrindavan， 我想知道主 Chaitanya 是否也有自己的灵性星球。Hare Krishna, obeisances to Guru. I want to ask the Krishna in the Goloka Vrindavan. I want to know whether the Lord Chaitanya also have his own spiritual plant.
Yes.
是的，也有。
Navadvip is there in the spiritual world.
Navadvip 在灵性世界也是有他的星球的。
You can go there and take part in the Sankirtan.
你可以去到那儿参加 Sankirtan 运动。Next question.
Yeah.
From Gadadhar Pandit Prabhu. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj. 认为 Vrindavan 和 Mayapu 之间有区别是一种冒犯，怎么理解？去过文达文，去过马埃普，还是感觉有区别的。所谓的没有区别指的是什么？还有如何对待有区别的地方 ？Hare Krishna, basis to Guru Maharaj. It is said that we should not consider the Vrindavan and the Mayapur they have some different. If we consider they have different, it's offense. How to understand that this is offense?
How to understand this is an offense?
Yeah, how to understand if we think of Vrindavan and Mayapur, they have difference, it's offense.
Well, there is a difference in the sense it's a different rasa there. That, you know, Vrindavan is the place of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.And Mayapur is a place of mercy, right? Mayapur is Odarya Dham, Odarya, it's Lord, in Vrindavan, it's very serious if you commit offenses. But Mayapur, Lord Chaitanya is very merciful and he doesn't consider offenses. And if you just lay down, you get the benefit of offering obeisances.So many benefits are there in Mayapur which are not there in Vrindavan, but Vrindavan is, you do devotional service in Vrindavan, it's very powerful. You get 100 times the benefit of any other place.
Vrindavan 和 Mayapur 之间Mayapur 之间 是有一些不同的。比如说在 Vrindavan, 在那里做奉献服务是非常强强有力量的。但是玛雅普呢，它又是被位于为是 Odaya Dham， 就是非常仁慈的一个圣地。在这里，你做任何冒犯，但是你祈求冒犯可以得到原谅。玛雅普是充满了仁慈的一个地方，但是文达文是非常严肃认真的一个地方。
Yeah, in Vrindavan.The mood, the Krishna's pastime is there. Krishna is there in his threefold bending form, playing the flute as a cowherd boy, he's the son of Nanda Maharaj. But in Mayapur, Krishna comes as the son of Sachi. In
Vrindavan, Krishna is a 一个木流童的身份显现在 Nanda Maharaj 的家中，而在 Mayapur, 他是作为 Sachi 的 撒奇母亲的儿子显现。
So the mood in Vrindavan is to worship, is Krishna is the supreme Lord, and the Krishna's Leela in Vrindavan is performing Leelas like Rasa Leela there with the gopis.
在 Vrindavan, Krishna 和这个牧牛姑娘们的这个 Rasa
But Lord Chaitanya, in Mayapur Dham, Navadvip Dham, he's performing Sankirtan.
就是说，在 Vrindavan 是 Krishna 和牧牛姑娘们之间的这种爱的关系的交流，而在 Mayapur 是主 Chaitanya 的 Sankirtan 运动所在之地。
So there's a difference in the mood, whole different atmosphere. Krishna is enjoying the company of the gopis, but in Lord Chaitanya's Leela, the gopis have all come in male form.
在 Krishna 的这个逍遥时光之中，那有很多的牧牛姑娘们，但是在主 Chaitanya, 他们以一种男性的，这些牧牛姑娘们以一种男性的形体显现。
So it's the same Krishna, but it's just in a different mood.
因此是同一个 Krishna, 但是是不同的心态。First question, he want to know why people say the Vrindavan and Mayapur is no difference, but when we say is have some difference, is offense.
Well, why do you say it has to have some difference? Yeah, it does have some difference, but...In the sense that there's no difference because it's Krishna's abode, it's the supreme abode.
它没有区别，是指 Krishna 都是至尊主 Krishna 的星球。
Just as Goloka is the supreme abode, Navadvip is also the supreme abode. It's the same supreme Lord.
就像 Navadvip 是至尊主的星球。Vrindavan 也是至尊主的星球，都是至尊主的星球。
Radha and Krishna become one from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Radha 和 Krishna 成为了一个，就是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So it's the same supreme abode, the same supreme Lord.
同一个至尊主，都是至尊主的星球。
So if you say there's a difference, then you're not understanding the identity.Of Lord Chaitanya.
如果你认为他们是有区别的，你没有理解到主 Chaitanya 的身份。Okay. Then he asked, when I go to Vrindavan, I find some feel have some difference. I think you also explained the difference. Then we can.
Okay.
Gadar Pandit also have another question. This question from new people. 怎样做到不杀生和非暴力 Ahimsa? 蚊子来攻击我们会拍死他们。种农作物时也会杀死一些生物。老鼠来了偷吃我们也会想办法抓住它。This question from a new people.How to become kill the other living entities and be ahimsa. When the mosquitoes attack us, we will kill them. When we plant the rice and other things, we will also kill other living entities. And the mouse steal our things.We will also want to catch this mouse. So
yes,
how to not kill any other living entities? How to become that?
Well, we don't intentionally go around killing any creatures.
我们不是有意的主动想要去杀死这些生物。
just like there may be some mosquitoes, okay, then we put on the fan or we use a mosquito net.
比如说有蚊子的时候，我们会打开电风扇，或者说用蚊帐。
Or put on some anti-mosquito repellent.
或者说在身上放一些那个驱蚊的药。
And if the mouse is coming, why is the mouse coming? Because we leave food lying around. If you don't leave food lying around, the mice will not come.
为什么老鼠会来了？是因为你留了一些食物。如果你没有在家里，在你的周围有这么多留剩下的食物的话，老鼠是不会来的。
So you have to keep everything clean and keep everything. Don't leave things laying around for the mouse to eat.
因此你得保持干净，不要在你的周围留下一些食物让老鼠来吃。
And when you're farming, you may have to plow the fields. Yeah, you have to plow the fields. You have to plant the land. You have to do that.
当你种植农作物的时候，你是得耕地。
We have to grow the grains. We need grains to eat.
我们得种植一些谷物，我们需要谷物去吃。
So that's not sinful. That's pious activity to do farming.
而种植谷物是不是罪恶的？是虔诚的活动。
You're producing grains. You can feed the animals. Animals eat grains. They enjoy.
你种植的谷物可以喂给这个动物，这个动物会很享受。
So the law of nature is one living entity is food for another.
大自然的法律是一个生物，它是另一个生物的食物。
Those living entities who have legs, they will eat those living entities which don't have legs.
那些有腿的会吃掉那些没有腿的。
Those living entities who have hands, they'll eat those which don't have hands.
那些有手的，他会吃掉那些没有手的。
So one living entity is a food for another. That's the law of nature. It's not sinful.
一个生物是另外一个生物的食物，这是一个大自然的法律，这不是罪恶。
So we grow the grains we offer to Krishna.
我们种植食物，我们种植谷物，我们供奉给 Krishna.
We offer whatever we produce from the land, we offer to Krishna for his pleasure, and we take Krishna's prasada. There is no sin. Okay.Satyamati.
Hare Krishna. 是的 ，Good day. 我们今天就到这里，可以结束了。
Okay. 我们感谢苏布德来给我们正太的翻译，感谢萨提主持，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，祝福你们生活快乐，唱诵并快乐。是了 ，Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Jai.
Jai. Go back to Vrinda ki.
Jai.